As you attain a higher level individual numeric frequency, it is important that you understand and are able to master the art of descension. As you descend to lower frequencies for various reasons, it's important that you do not allow that journey to impact your vibration too much. In other words, as someone who is in the midst of walking through the portal that is 18 frequency, sometimes I will descend, I will travel, and I will go, let's say, into the world of 14 frequency experiences and banter and knowledge and perspective, because that itself is a frequency that is more comfortable for me, more relatable to me than 13 frequency entertainment or banter. Okay, I am a live path four. I am very much comfortable in that frequency. While there is a simultaneous discomfort for me there, right? Because of the fact that I understand things from a higher level now, I've mentally ascended beyond that frequency, generally speaking. So there are certain concepts, perspectives that are held in that frequency that I've grown beyond. With that being said, this is important because there is a reason why 13 frequency beings and 14 frequency beings just clash so profoundly. And it's because of the fact that once you hit that frequency or that level where you are truly in that state of observation, of awareness, of judging, of judgment, you're going to look around at things that are currently in place and just want to destroy it all, because it's all profoundly flawed once you gain a certain level of awareness. But here is some 18 frequency wisdom I want to express to you. As a creator, once you have gained that right to call yourself a creator, because you have aligned with the 8 frequency in such a way that you are truly serving as a vessel of creation, of originality, right? It's completely different than lower frequency manifestation. It is high level manifestation. It is creating from a void. It is creating without reference point. It is truly creating from spirit. Okay? It's very unique. Collectively speaking, okay? A lot of systems in place, a lot of ideologies in place, a lot of people's opinions are taught to them. They're patterning their loved ones. They're patterning society. It's not originality. And with that being said, there are two sides to that coin. It is a natural opposition. It is a natural shadow as a creator to also be an equally skilled being in the realm of destruction. It is a natural effect of creation, but you need to make sure it is that. You need to make sure that anything that is destroyed is the natural consequence of your creation. Don't sit around trying to destroy things based on your word alone, based on your perspective, without giving the world something better than what you're trying to destroy. Because if you are going to destroy someone's map that is keeping them sane, you better be able to throw them a life raft after you've demolished it. Okay? It's simple compassion. Okay? It doesn't mean that systems don't need to be destroyed. Doesn't mean that the world doesn't desperately need these shifts to occur. But what it means is we need to do these things strategically. Okay? For me, I've always embraced that spirit of change, of shift, of awareness, of expansion. I got excited being shifted out of my belief systems. I got excited gaining consciousness. I got excited when my spiritual eye just saw things in a new way. It excited me, that level of traumatic jolting, perspectively speaking, right? It excited me. it made me feel more connected with God, with the universe, especially because these shifts were resulting from my prayers to God to teach me more, to teach me the secrets. These prayers for me began in 2015, okay? But it's a journey. It takes years, 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 years. Ascension does not happen overnight. And that's something else that's, in closing, I want to express that, because when I talk about these things, you guys, I'm sharing my experience with you. And frequency shifting, ascension, is not without difficulty. And when you achieve a certain frequency, when you reach 18, as I have, it can be so hard watching others not ascend or ascend at a very slow pace, and holding and grasping and clawing onto belief systems that are dead or dying, that are flawed and hindering, because it's what they know. Their whole world gravitates around this, hence the term worldview. And it can be easy for me to forget how long it has actually taken me to get here, especially now that I have developed a system that lays it out damn near in black and white for people to follow and hopefully make their ascension process a little bit quicker. But the reality of that is that no matter how clear and precise and accurate and effective my system is, expressing it to a 13 frequency being or below, unless it's 12 frequency relative to their true love of God, but even that's difficult because that's typically going to be a religious perspective as opposed to a spiritual one, because it is lower frequency. It won't be perceived the same. It won't be perceived in a manner that's actually going to change them. So that's why understanding frequency is so important. And understanding it as a journey is so important. And as a creator of a system, an ascension tool, a numeric ascension tool, doesn't make it any easier for me sometimes. I forget too, because I want to rush people, and you can't. All I can do is continue to be me, share what I know, let people use it when they're ready, and watch those who are ready to fly do just that.